Hi, I'm Aaron from Solace. This is part two of my Solace Java samples videos, where I'm going to look at some code and talk a little bit about best practices. In my last video, I showed you how to download, build, and run the Java samples. In this one, we're going to take a look at some source code. So as you would expect, the Java files are all located in the source folder. You can browse them and check them out. There's the topic publisher and subscriber that we ran last time, as well as the other samples that are included. Of course, you can actually take a look at the source code right here in GitHub or in your text editor of choice, but I thought I would show you a cool feature of Gradle that some of you might find useful. So if you go back to the README and scroll down just a little bit further than we got to last time, you'll see that Gradle has some built-in features, built-in tasks that allow you to import it into your favorite IDE. So for example, if you're using Eclipse, Gradle will actually go ahead and create the class path and project files needed to import the samples as an Eclipse project. So the example here they give would be useful if you're on a Mac or a Linux machine using the shell script, but because I'm on Windows, I actually need to use the batch file for this one specifically because the class path file that it generates needs to have Windows paths. So if you're on a Windows machine, you need to use the command prompt for this one. Go ahead and kick that off. And you can see that Gradle has indeed built a class path, a .project, and a .settings directory, everything needed to import into Eclipse. So head over to Eclipse, file import. Now, if you have the Gradle plugins configured in Eclipse, you can import this as a Gradle project, and then Eclipse will know how to build everything using the gradle.build file. Otherwise, just import it as a regular project, a regular Java project, and that will work just fine. Browse to your downloads directory or wherever you unpacked it to. Click finish. And there you go. Eclipse has now imported the Solace samples as a Java project. And because Gradle has already built the class path file, all of the reference library is already there. There's a Solace messaging API and a couple other dependencies that it needs. And all the source files have been imported and compiled without issue. So that's good. So let's take a look at the topic publisher and subscriber that we were looking at before. Now, one thing to keep in mind is these are simple hello world intro sample examples. They're not meant to be indicative of best practices, and they're definitely not ready to be deployed straight away into production without some additional tweaks and configuration, so which I'll talk about in just a second. You can see everything is kind of stuck into the main method here. It reads some stuff off the command line, and then builds a properties object, which it then populates with those arguments, username, password, VPN name. It creates a topic object with our topic that we've defined, creates a session object, which is going to be the actual connection into the Solace broker, and using those properties goes ahead and connects into Solace. It then defines a callback, an onReceive method. This is a method that's run by the API when it receives a message for the subscriber. And you can see that we don't do very much with that. We just kind of print it out in the console. We do a message.dump and then unblock this latch that we've defined up here with a count of one. This is why the subscriber just receives one message before disconnecting. In the exception handling, same kind of thing. It just kind of like writes it out to the console and then unblocks the latch. So now that we've connected, it adds a topic subscription. It adds that subscription, starts the consumer ready to receive messages, and there sits there waiting on that latch to unblock, waiting for that single message to come on the callback before exiting. Similarly, on the topic publisher side, very similar looking code, reads stuff off the command line, generates the properties object, creates a session using those properties, and connects into Solace. It then defines that same topic object, and here it defines some publishing callbacks. This is a way for the API to signal to the application when issues occur with the publishing side. And again, as you can see, it doesn't do very much except prints it out to the console. Once we've connected, we go ahead and create a text message object. In Solace, there are bytes message as well. There's map message, stream message. It populates the payload with a hello world, and then sends that message on that particular topic, and then exits. So very simple, little simple app, publishes, connects, publishes one message, and disconnects. So this is one example of how it's not quite a production ready application. You know, typically a real application would be both a subscriber and a publisher. Even if you're mostly a subscriber or mostly a publisher, you'd still want to probably be able to receive messages or send messages such as heartbeats or health checks or command and control type messages to maybe other applications in your environment. Also, all this printing to the console is not very production ready. Solace, the Java APIs have built-in logging using the Apache Commons logging framework, which you can use with Log4j. And yeah, sending one message at a time. Typically, your application would stay online for as long as possible. Your main thread would not be it would go into a while loop, waiting on maybe some kind of external input or a straight transition to unblock. And so in your subscriber, you wouldn't have a latch. You should get rid of this code right away and basically have your main thread just sitting there receiving messages constantly, streaming messages in, publishing messages out, and waiting until, not sending one message at a time. So there you go, a really quick crash course on some Solace code. If you wanted to run it, obviously, in Eclipse, you just say run as Java application. It would ask you for those command line parameters, which you could go up here into the run configuration and give it the same parameters that we had last time. Default, no password required. Tell it to run. There we go. My subscriber connects and is sitting there waiting a message, just like when we were doing on the command line. Okay, that was a quick look at some Solace Java code and a couple best practice tips. For much more information on our Java API and a bunch more best practices, make sure to check out our documentation portal at docs.solace.com. In my next video, I'm going to take a look at some of the other samples that are included and talk about how request reply, queuing, and persistent messaging can all be combined with pub sub to form all sorts of different communication patterns for your applications and microservices. So check it out. Thanks.